Hey guys, once again, welcome back to the brand new video. In this video, we are going to create a clean and simple motion graphics animation inside of DaVinci Resolve 18. This video contains lots of value because we are going to take a look at how to create a strokes animation inside of DaVinci Resolve by using B-Spline, how to use the follower modifier of the text tool, and how to compose all these things together and create a stunning motion graphics. I will recommend you to watch this video till the end to enhance your motion graphics and creative skill in DaVinci Resolve. So this is Vikas from Skyline Motions, and without any further ado, let's take a new project and get started. Alright, so here we are in DaVinci Resolve 18, and before we get started, we have to do some basic setting as usual. So click on the setting button in the corner and set the size of this project 1920 by 1080. Select the frame rate 60 frames per second for smooth animation and click on save. Now we have to create this animation inside of the Fusion page, so we have to take a new Fusion composition first. So just go to the media pool, right click on that, click on new Fusion composition. Let's call it Fusion composition or Fusion. Duration maybe 4 seconds long, which is good enough for one slide. Click on create. Now drag this Fusion composition on the timeline just like that, and then you can go to the Fusion page. And here we have the media out node, so just drag this media out to the side for now. And now let's start by creating a background. So this is the background node. Let's drag and drop on the floor window. Drag this background to the viewer, and here we have to select a gray color. So just go to the color in the inspector window, and here you can select the gray color just like that. You can set the value over here. So I'm going to set the value of RGB maybe 0.04. So let's set the value 0.04. Just like that. Let's attach our text node. So this is the text. Let's drag and drop on the flow window, and we have to merge this text with the background. So it's very simple. You can connect the output of this text with the background and you will get a new merge. Let's drag the merge one to the viewer. Select the text and type anything, whatever you want. After that, we have to select our favorite font style. So in this case, I'm using the lemon milk font style. You can use any font style that you like. Set it to medium. Let's increase the size a little bit. So I'm going to set the value maybe 0.25. Select the color pure white. And after that, we have to animate the text. So it's very simple again. Just select the text and go to the styled text. And here, we're going to use this follower modifier. So click on the follower. And then here we have the modifier. So just go to the modifier, and inside of the modifier we have the timing and the text transform setting. So just go to the setting, and here we have to animate the opacity and the position. So let's animate the position first. So just go to the position, and here we have the offset X and Y. So we have to animate the Y position. So what we have to do, just right click on offset, go to modify with, select this option XY path. Now we need only Y direction, so let's remove the animation from the X parameter. So right click on X, click on remove XY path. Just go to on frame number 30, which is equal to half a second. Right click on Y parameter, click on set key. Just go to very first frame of this animation, and you can change the position. So I'm going to set the value maybe -1 maybe, and we will get this type of animation. After that, we have to animate the opacity. So just go to on frame number 30, let's go to the follower, and here we have the opacity. So right click on opacity, click on animate, go to very first frame of this animation. Let's set the opacity 0, and now we will get this type of animation. So this animation is a linear right now, so let's make it smoother. Just go to spline window, hit F4 on the keyboard to full screen. Here we have the Y parameter, so check this Y, click on fit, select both the keyframes, hit S on the keyboard to a smooth, or you can also click on this smooth button, hold this handle and create a smooth curve just like that. You can adjust this handle and create the smooth animation according to you, and click on spline window. Now we will get something like this, but we have to create a time gap between each character. So just go to the modifier again, and here we have the timing. So just go to the timing and let's increase the delay value. So I'm going to set the delay maybe 5 frame, and then we will get something like this, which is looking absolutely perfect. Now we have to animate a stroke over here. So it's very simple again. We need to add B-Spline tool. So this is the B-Spline tool. Let's drag and drop on the flow window. And here we have to create a curve. Just like that. Perfect. And then you can drag this B-Spline to the viewer. And here we have the border width. So let's increase the border width and set it to 0.015, and we will get this type of thick stroke. Now you can uncheck the solid box, and here we have the length, so you can animate the length. So just go to on frame number 60, but before that we have to remove the animation. So just click on this option and click on remove B-spline 1 polyline because we don't need it. Let's go to on frame number 60, which is equal to 1 second, and here we have the length. So right click on length, click on animate, go to very first frame of this animation, set the length value 0, and we will get this type of a stroke animation. And then just go to on frame number 90, which is equal to 1.5 second, and here we have the position. So right click on position, click on animate, set the position value 1. Let's go to on frame number 30, which is equal to 0.5 second, and set the position 0. So we will get this type of stroke animation. Now we have to do one more thing. Just go to on frame number 90, right click on border width, click on animate, and then just go to on frame number 45, and then we have to create a keyframe. So just right click on border width, click on set key, and lock the value as it is at 45 frame, and then go to the 90 frame over here, and you can set the border width 0. And now at the end of this animation you can see the stroke thickness animation. Now let's go to spline window, hit F4 on the keyboard to full screen, and this time we need only B-spline, so you can uncheck the text, and here we have the B-spline. So let's uncheck the border width position. We have to check the length only. Click on fit, select both the keyframes, hit S to smooth, hold this handle and set it like this. Now we have to do the same thing with the position and the border width. So I'm going to do this in fast forward. Perfect. Now we have the smooth animation, as you can see. Now you can close this spline window from here. Now I'm going to use this spline on a background, so we have to take a new background node. So this is the background. Let's drag and drop on the flow window, select the background, hit F2, call it color, hit OK. Now I'm going to attach this B spline with the background, and you can see the effect over here. Now select the color, and we have to create a gradient color. So just go to the type and change this to gradient, and here we have two different gradient colors. So select the first color, and you can create unique color combination just like so. Perfect. So we will get this type of gradient color. Now we have to merge this stroke animation with the text. So that's very simple again. Let's take a new merge node, and I'm going to use this text as a foreground and this color stroke as a background. So what we have to do, just deattach this connection, and inside of the merge node we have four different points. So the yellow point is for background, green is for foreground, and this is the output. So connect the output with this merge one, and connect the yellow background point with this stroke and green foreground point with the text. And now you can drag this merge one to the viewer, and as you can see we will get something like this, which is looking absolutely perfect. All right, and now let's create the another thing. So select the text node, hit Ctrl C to copy, or you can also right click on the text and click on copy, and we have to paste an instance copy over here. So just right click on this flow window, click on paste instance. So this is not a normal copy, it is an instance copy of this text one. It means both are interconnected with each other. So if you want to change something in both the text, you only have to change in the text one. Now we have to create an instance copy of the color as well. So select the color node, right click on that, click on copy, and paste an instance copy over here. And now I'm going to place this color inside of the text. So what we have to do, let's take a new merge node, and I'm going to use this text as a background. So connect the yellow background point with this instance text one, and I'm going to use this color as a foreground. So connect the green point, the foreground point with the instance color, and drag this merge 3 to the viewer. Now select the merge and change this operator over to in, and now you can see the color only in the text shape. Now select the instance color 1 and you can set the gradient points over here maybe, and create a nice and simple gradient color combination. After that, we have to attach a background with this. So we have to create one more background. So this is the background. Drag and drop on the flow window. Now we have to connect the background with this text. So let's take a new merge node. I'm going to use this output as a foreground and this one as a background. So connect the yellow point with the background and green foreground point with the merge 3, and drag this merge 4 to the viewer. Now we have to change the color a little bit. So select the background, and here we have the color. You can select a light gray color just like that. You can set the RGB value from here. So I'm going to set the RGB value 0.08. Just like so, and now we will get something like this. And after that, we have two different outputs. So let's see, just click on the double viewer. So this is the first output and this is the second output. So both are looking like this. And after that, let's take a new background node. Select the background, hit F2, call it shape, hit OK. Select the shape and attach a rectangular mask with this, just like that. And here we have to change the rectangle settings. So I'm going to set the width value maybe 1, height value 1.8 maybe. Let's increase the corner radius and set the value 0.25. and here we have the angle, so let's rotate the angle maybe -45 degrees. And after that, we have to animate the shape layer. So first, place the shape over here and set the value of the center X maybe 0.12, and just go to on frame number 90, which is equal to 1.5 seconds. Right click on center, click on animate, and go to on frame number 30, which is equal to 0.5 seconds. Let's drag the shape outside of this frame and set the center X value maybe -0.7. Alright, and then just go to on frame number 150, which is equal to 2.5 seconds. Right click on center, click on set key, and lock the position as it is. Just go to 1 second forward in time, so it should be 210 frame according to 60 frame per second. And let's drag the shape outside of the frame just like that. So set the center X value maybe 1.7. Alright, so this animation is linear right now, so let's make it smoother. Just go to spline window, hit F4 on the keyboard to full screen. You can minimize all the nodes. And here we have the rectangle one, so uncheck the B-Spline, check the rectangle one only, click on fit button, highlight these keyframes, hit S to smooth, hold this handle and create a nice smooth curve just like that. Select these two keyframes, hit S to smooth, hold this handle and create a nice smooth curve just like that, and close this spline window. Perfect. And then we have this type of shape animation, as you can see. Now you can click on the single viewer. Alright, so we have this type of shape animation, and I'm gonna place this output inside of the shape. So what we have to do, let's take a new merge node, and I'm gonna use this shape output as a background and this output as a foreground. So connect the green foreground point with this and yellow background point with this shape, and here we have the merge 5. Let's drag and drop to the viewer. Select the merge 5, go to operator and change this over to in, and finally we will get something like this. Alright, now we have two different output. The first output is looking like this and the second output is looking like this, and I'm gonna merge both the outputs. So let's take a new merge node, and I'm gonna use this output as a background. So connect the yellow background point with this and green foreground point with this, and this is the merge 6. Let's drag and drop to the viewer. Alright, and after that, I'm going to attach a drop shadow effect over here. So select the merge 5, hit Ctrl plus the spacebar for search box and search for drop shadow. So this is the drop shadow effect, hit add button, select the drop shadow, and here we have the drop distance. Let's set the drop distance 0 and make it like this. And now we have a nice drop shadow effect. Click on fit button. And now we have to do one more thing. Just go to on frame number 150 and let's hide the white text. So just go to on 150 and here we have both the text. So this is the white text and this is the colorful text, as you can see. So select the text one and we have to animate the write on over here, but both are interconnected with each other. So we have to unlink this parameter only. So just go to on instance text one and here the green box is indication of connection. So just right click on write on and here we have the deinstance int group. So click on this option deinstance int group and now go to the text one and here we have to animate the write on. So just go to on frame number 150, right click on the write on, click on animate and set it to 0. Just go back one frame and set the write on value 1. Now you can see the final output and here we have the white text, but after this frame there is no white text over here. And then you can connect the media out with the main output just like so, and then you can go to the edit page and here our animation is ready for render. Perfect. Now let me show you how you can create multiple copy of this. So it's very simple. Select the fusion composition, hit Ctrl C to copy, hit Ctrl V to paste, place the CTI on the second copy and go to the fusion page and here you can change the text. So select the text one only and here you can type anything whatever you want, just like that. And you can change the color as well. So select the color and here you can change anything. And after that, we will get this type of nice and simple gradient color. And then you can go to the edit page and here we have the first slide and the second slide. And now turn on the loop button, go to very first frame of this animation and let's have a look. Alright, so that is it guys. I hope you like this video. If you have any question, drop a message on my Instagram or comment down below. And if you are watching this video first time on this channel, please hit the subscribe button, turn on the bell notification for more interesting videos. My name is Vikash and I will see you in the next one. Till then, bye bye.